basketball is a very complex sport. We need everything. So if you are looking with full respect of other athletes, rugby is a great example. They can kill basketball players. But if you are looking for some other athletes from different sports, like football, like volleyball, I don't think they are better athletes than basketball players. So because basketball is very complex as a sport, for example, I'm saying just full respect of Lionel Messi, but I don't think that he can be successful in any other sport except football, because he's genius for football. But conditioning stuff of Westbrook, LeBron James, or some top European players are so good that they can be successful also in other sport. Why? Because we are basketball conditioning is very difficult, very complex. We need everything. We need speed, power, coordination, different kind of endurance, precision, agility, quickness, all the stuff. How to combine those stuff and how to put together in under 14 basketball practice, I will try to find some answer on some questions. As I said before, there is a consensus between experts about volume of the practice. So things to consider more when you are going to make practice plan is intensity. How to combine intensity, and another stuff which is very important, which kind of skills we should develop in specific age of players. Probably you know something about sensitive zones or windows of trainability. It's very important to understand in which age we should develop some specific skills. Because windows of trainability means age of player's development, when with well-organized practice we can have big impact on development of specific skill. For example, if you are going to talk about coordination from the beginning, 6-7 years old to 11-12 is best part to develop coordination. That's mean basketball technique for us, crossing steps, dribble between the legs, behind the back. Because after that, the girls a little bit early, in 9-10, they are going to grow up in 2 years, probably 20 centimeters. Definitely, this is not good time to develop coordination. But we should have in mind that even with good practice, we should work on coordination, having in mind that we cannot develop so well, we will get fruits of that work before, when they are going to stop growing up in next part. For speed, as a very important conditioning skill or ability, we should understand that speed we should develop immediately. So kids can perform maximal speed even when they are 6-7 years old. But from the other side, we should push them to work on speed only on technical stuff which they are doing technically correctly. So for us in basketball, I think first thing is correct execution. After that, repetitions, and after that, intensity. You cannot pretend from them to make with maximal speed something which they are not doing correctly. Because if they are doing like this, they will create bad habits, and after that, it's very difficult to break bad habits to go back to the right habits. So this is very important to understand. Windows of trainabilities, what we can do. After that, basketball is anaerobic sport. But of course, as Coach Martin said before, we need also aerobic endurance because of recovering time. Aerobic general endurance we should develop in certain age, also in under 14, because after that, in the late part of career, they should recover better, they can recover better if they have higher level of aerobic endurance. For example, we discussed just last summer with top coaches on FSSC course, Pablo Lasso said that if he is going to qualify for the final of Endesa League and final four, he will have 97 official games this season. So this is terrible. So how to organize this recovering time? Level of aerobic endurance will help him to recover better between two games. So we should think about it when they are under 14. After that, of course, as Martin said, that was a very good point. If you are talking about speed, we have not maximal speed, running of maximal speed, because we need minimum 40-50 meters, and our court is 28. So, related to speed, we need to develop speed reaction, acceleration, deceleration, and change of direction. And this is practically agility. So, ability to make quick change of direction in short space. This is agility. So we should work on those skills with ball and without the ball, of course. So now I'm going to run to show you some way how to connect basketball with conditioning. Because as I said before, they are not professional players in under 14, in under 12. We have no time like in senior teams to say, okay, Monday morning we are going to work on speed. Thursday afternoon we have 15 minutes for weightlifting or something like that. So we as a coaches or you as a coaches in under 14, we should combine conditioning practice with basketball practice as more as possible in order to be effective and in order to be specific. But from the other side, we should understand in which metabolic zone we are going to work, because we have aerobic endurance, we have aerobic lactate or phosphagen endurance, and we have aerobic lactate endurance or glycolytic endurance. So we should understand in which zone we are going to work in order to cover all demands from top basketball in order to develop them. Of course, all those stuff which I'm going to show to you right now, you cannot use in one practice. So it's about periodization of the practice, about practice plan. For example, very important teaching point for you should be, if you want to develop speed, agility, quickness, explosive power, we need fresh body. That means that we should work on those skills at the beginning of the week, after day off, when players are ready for that. And also, considering one practice, we should work on those skills at the beginning of the main part of the practice. When they are ready, after good warm-up, we should develop all skills. If you are talking about aerobic endurance, we should work on aerobic endurance. Also, we can work also in the second part, in the last part of the main part of the practice, or in the end of the week, when players are tired. Because general endurance, especially aerobic endurance, is resistance of tiredness. So they should be tired to postpone reaction on tiredness. This is endurance. So all those stuff, of course, you can find in theory of sports training, but now I'm going to run some drills, and for all drills, I'm going to show to you and to say to you on which skills, on which conditioning ability we are going to work. Okay, let's, of course, connecting with basketball. So most of the drills we are going to do with balls, connecting basketball skills and some other stuff. Okay, let's make, guys, Martin, Milena, six players, two balls, 12 players, two balls, six pairs of two. Let's start with some warm-up, fast break, opening and different way of finishing. Everybody here, two players, one ball, okay? One of you is going, you understand English? You understand? Yes? Okay. You are going to be rebounder. You go from elbow here. You are guard. Okay. Of course, in under 14, we have not specialization by position. So all the players must do all the stuff. Even if they are big, tall, they should know how to pass the ball, how to run, how to make outlet pass, how to play face to the basket, and how to play back to the basket. This is very important because specialization by position we are going to make in under 16. Perimeter players, inside players. Even if we know now who of them is going to be big and who is going to be perimeter player, we are going to work on the same skills. Because we need big players with skills and small players also with skill of big guy. Okay, simple stuff. We can do all of them, you know. All of them can do. Okay, let's try to do fast break opening with different finishing. First lap. You're doing two laps. You should put the ball on the glass, try to open outside, okay? I don't want to talk now about technical stuff, but I prefer to teach kids to be open on the three-point level, because usually coaches are saying under free throw level, and in the game situation, they are going to receive ball here. So, no fast break from here. So, try to be open on the three-point level. Try to have to be in a lateral position, so back to the sideline. Like this, when you receive the ball, you can see all the court, you can deliver the pass easily. Show target hand. When you pass the ball to him, okay, you try to use over the head pass or one hand pass. You just dribble in the middle, you go outside, finish, score, and after that, immediately, without putting ball on the glass, go back opposite side. Do you understand? So you are going to score After scoring, go you to be open on the side, you pass to him and just finish two courts. Okay, one by one, we can do one lap everybody, simple stuff. Okay, you can make, come on guys, bring the ball, bring the balls, bring the balls, two players, one ball, come on. When they are arriving, you can start immediately. Come on, let's go, just put the ball and go, run fast break. Come on, pass, run, stop, cross with him. You go behind, you dribble in the middle, okay, you go behind him. When you receive the ball, dribble in the middle, okay, middle court, let's make change behind the back, pass to him, no dribble over there, you should score without dribble. After scoring, you are running outside, you pass and you go to score. Do you understand? Okay, let's go. Put the ball on the glass, pass to him, let's go, run, run. Left hand dribble, go, next. Come on, pass. Stop. Go back. Technical stuff, coaches. You pass the ball with left hand. Is it possible in the game situation? No way. Go back, run over there. Run you over there. I'm here in front of you, defender. How you will pass to him? One hand of the dribble pass. You should score from right side, right hand layup. Don't do opposite. Go back again. Come on. Right side, right hand. We teach them in under 14, I say to previous session, of the dribble pass. This is most important pass in today basketball. Of the dribble one hand pass. Come on, come on, let's go. Next group, Martin, prepare next group immediately. Go, go, go. Of the dribble pass, bravo, come on. No dribble, go. Okay, let's go, pass to him. Go you behind, dribble. Come on, let's go. Next one, out of the cone. Pass to him. Pass to him immediately, eh? Again, left hand. Right hand pass, eh? You don't need to put on the glass. Pass to him. You run outside. Dribble in the middle. Outside. Come on. Let's go. Dribble. Left hand dribble. Come on. Faster. No dribble on the layup. Stop. Go. Try to score. Score. Finish. You stop, make one lap and stop. Of course, coaches, you are not going to stop every second. I'm just going to show to you more options. You are running 6 courts, 8 courts, one option, and after that you are going to change. Because we should connect with basketball. Now, you should pass to him in that way, a little bit before, that in the moment of the receiving, you should make one dribble on the baseline and score. Lay up after one dribble. Pass to him a little bit before. Okay? Same stuff, just one dribble and layup. Come on, let's go. Just one lap and we are going to change. Pass, go. Next. Pass. No, before. Stop. This is fast break situation. Okay? Stay here in the middle. This is fast break situation. So in under 14, especially big guys here, one dribble is enough to score. So you should pass ball to him out of the 3-point line. From here, pass to me. From here, you should rip the ball here, one dribble and layup. I don't want you to dribble here. Okay, go back again. So pass the ball out of the 3-point line, because we should teach them to score just with one dribble out of the 3-point, even in under 14. Come on, let's go. Let's go, faster. Come on, sprint, next. Pass, too late. Come on, dribble. Pass, too late. Out of the 3-point. Come on, pass. One dribble. Bravo. Let's go. Next one. Pass. Direct pass. We are playing fast break. We want direct passes. We don't want bounce pass. Pass. One dribble. Go. Okay. Now, same stuff. Dribble in the middle. Left hand layup. But pass to him on the 3-point level. Okay. When you receive the ball, just dribble in the middle. Left hand layup. Come on. Let's go. Faster. Come on. Pass. Show target hand. Dribble. Pass. Dribble in the middle. One dribble in the middle. Simple stuff. Let's go. Pass. Late. Try to avoid traveling. I say one dribble. He made two. We want one. We don't want to teach them to make 5 dribbles. Late pass. Milena, give me one cone, please. Okay, stop. Okay, put same over there. Give me one more and put two over there. If they are not going to listen, you should put cons. Okay, offensive player who is running here must receive the ball here and from here drive in the middle, one dribble layup. Same over there. Come on. In front of con. They should think about timing and spacing. Go, go. Come on, come on. Faster, faster, faster. Go. Come on. So you can see how many problems we have to organize simple stuff. One dribble drive. Come on. I don't want to talk now about technical stuff. Rip the ball, ball on the hip. Put the dribble on the floor. Ball on the shoulder. Extended layup. This is something else. Come on. Pass and go. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on, come on, come on. Let's go. Sprint, sprint, sprint. Of course, coaches, you are not going to change so fast. I'm going to show to you more options. If you are going to run this drill just with one sentence, you are going to change everything. They don't need to stop. You are just saying one sentence and they are going to run. 10, 15 minutes, this is also aerobic endurance. So it's up to you to decide. Now we are going to do one dribble, reverse layup, right hand, right layup. Okay, reverse layup. Let's go. Right hand, same stuff. Go, dribble. Receive the ball. Pass, pass. Come on. One dribble, reverse layup. Let's go, let's go. Next, next. Try to score. Sometime we should score. Come on. Stop the ball, reverse layup. One dribble, reverse. Let's go, let's go. Next, 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 next. Come on, guys. 2-0, hey. One dribble, it's enough. Come on. Come on. You can do it because they are on the full sprint. They can't do it. It's just bad habit. Come on. Okay. Go, go, go. Now, next option. Right layup, shoot, reverse with left hand. Okay, but right layup. Right steps, just you shoot with left hand. Over the head. Let's go. Let's go. Pass, pass. Sprint, sprint. Come on, come on. Opposite, opposite, reverse, reverse, reverse. Okay, make two dribbles, make two dribbles. Make two dribbles, come on. One, two, reverse, no. Stop, stop. Pass to me. Give me a ball. Show me. Mid. Okay, okay, stop. So, you are going to do reverse layup, right hand, left shooting. Okay, right leg, left arm. Try to do this one more time. Come on. Come on, let's go. Make two dribbles. Run outside. Pass, pass. Come on, two dribbles. One, two, reverse. Left hand shooting. Hey. Left hand shooting. Come on, so different way of finishing in fast break. Come on, guys, let's go. Right layup, left hand. Okay, give me a ball. Now we are doing one step layup. So you receive ball here. You receive the ball here. Now you are doing one, two, and one step shoot with right hand. Okay? So different way of finishing under 14 they should work on. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Stopped over there. Pass. Come on. Come on. Let's go. Hop. One. Two, one, but right hand, come on, right hand, hop, middle, right hand, yes, bravo, that was good, let's go, one, yes, bravo, try to get closer to the basket, I don't want to teach them floater right now, this is normal, layup, one step, one shot, come on, one, two, go. Finish? Okay. Okay, everybody with ball, if you are using just a couple of options, or if you are using all options, 10-15 minutes is enough. Okay, now it's time to make some dynamic mobility drills. I'm not going to show you because we have no time. You have on internet everything. Let's go, everybody with ball on the sideline here. Everybody with ball sideline. Milena, Milena. Now from here and from opposite side, just put cones like zigzag here, here, wherever you want. So after that, for next drill, just cones. Okay, we are doing like this and same over there. Now injury prevention and also coordination, hand-eye coordination. Okay, we are going to do this, guys. Okay, give me one ball. You start to dribble and you make three steps and stop. Okay, let's make like this. One, two, three, stop. One, two, three, stop. Okay, let's try to do this. One, two, three, stop. Balance, knee balance and coordination. Stop and go, stop and go. Stay low. Yes, like this, super. And one more here. Do the same, do the same. Go back, jump, come on. But get close, get low. Stay low, stay low. Come on. This is good drill for injury prevention at the beginning for the kids. Okay, now we are doing the same, but in the moment of the stop, you're going to close eyes. So one, two, three, stop, be in good balance. When you're in good balance, open eyes and dribble again. Okay, change, dribble with left hand right now. Come on, we change, one, two, three. Stay low, stay low. Stop, stop. Go back. I didn't show to you to run like this. So you should stay low. One, two, three. This is position. Okay, not this. Okay, bend your knees. Come on. Come on. Close eyes. Close eyes. One, two, three. Close eyes. Eye-hand coordination, balance, knee stability, ankle stability. Different stuff. It's still warm up. Okay, try to do same moving backward. Now it's difficult. Let's go. Stay, sit down, sit down. Stay low, stay low, stay low, stay low. Bend your knees, come on. Stay low. You can see immediately who of players has the problem with ankle, who of players has the problem with knee, with lower back. You can do same drill with two balls. You can do same drill with one volleyball ball and with one basketball ball. You can do same drill with tennis balls. It's up to you how to develop drills. But principle is the same. Okay, let's do now some resistance part of the practice. For kids, explosive power, acceleration. Six players, two balls. So just every second player put the ball on the basket. Come on. Okay, let's go everybody over there. Come on, come on. Go over there. Faster. Okay, stay here on this line. Okay, B players similar size pairs. Okay, you and you, come on. Okay, so you are going here. You go behind him. Stay on the sideline. Stay on the sideline here. Okay. You are going to hold him here, okay? And you are going to dribble crossover all the time and to run with resistance, okay? Important stuff for kids. I don't want to have legs here because probably he's going to put his foot on my foot in order to avoid distortion. Stay wide. Okay, go, go. Change, change all the time. Okay, like this. Come on, go over there and after that switch. Come on, go, go, go. Run, run, run. I don't want you to move. Run, 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 run. Come on. Let's go. Bravo. Okay, change, change, switch, switch positions, switch, switch, run. They are moving with, I want them to run and to make change. Let's go, let's go. Come on. Give him some resistance. Okay, now we are doing opposite. Bring the ball. Come on, dribble, 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 change direction, I'm going to make some resistance, okay? Let's do this. Change offense, defense. Opposite side. Come on. All the time crossover, all the time crossover, all the time crossover, come on. Come on, again, again. Okay, change, 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 go back. That stuff you should work after warm up when they are ready. So this is perfect time for that kind of drills. Milena, Milena, tennis balls. Give me two tennis balls. Come on, one player, number 7, come here. Speed reaction. Beginning of the main part of the practice when they're ready. You can make, if you are on the individual practice, is not a problem to organize. If you are on the team practice, you can make different groups. So one player is going to do. Now we have no time to organize this. I'm going to show you some simple drills for him. Okay, speed reaction. You should react. Okay, stay over there, back to this bus. Here, here, here. Okay, ready to check the ball. Pass to me, pass to me. Immediately pass back. Come on. Come on, immediately pass back. Come on. Ball can't touch the floor once. Ball can't touch the floor once. Come on. Let's go. So, if you want to work on speed, 6 to 8 seconds. Anaerobic lactate endurance. That drill cannot be 20 seconds. Can be 20, 30 if you want to work on aerobic lactate endurance. Okay, speed reaction again. Stay in this position. Back to me, back to me. Like this. You know who is Rocky Balboa? Did you see movie Rocky Balboa when he's going to run to get chicken over there? You don't know that stuff? Okay, this is chicken. You should run. Okay, I'm going to put one ball and another ball. You should try to catch as soon as possible, as fast as possible, both balls. Ready? Come on. Speed, reaction, acceleration, deceleration. Again. Come on. Ready? Come on. Go. Go. That was good. When he was running, he was looking for another stuff. Very good. Okay. Something like that you can do. You can do the same with basketball. Rolling basketball and work on speed reaction. Okay. Let's go, everybody, here with ball. Martin, you stay here. Milena, you stay over there. Now we are going to connect jumping ability, change of direction, penetration. Okay. You should jump over the hurdles here with ball. Okay, on the last hurdle, coaches is going to show to you sight. So you should read peripheral vision. Over there, coach is going to show to you left, right. You are going to change direction here or here. And then zigzag over there, layup. That side. Okay, over there, you're doing the same. But on hurdles over there, you're doing jump, lateral side, jump, lateral side. Okay, same stuff. Come on. After last, they're going to make layup. Okay, just show to them over there. Let's go. Let's go. Jump, jump, jump. Faster, faster, faster. Change in front. Hey, stop, stop. You should change here. This is defender. You should change here. Okay, you don't need to go around. We are not in skiing to run slalom, you know. Okay, change direction. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Hop, 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 jump, move. Hop, change, full speed, full speed, full speed. Change direction. You should decide about technical stuff. I don't want to waste time now to explain to you because you can decide about technical stuff. I'm going to explain just connection between conditioning and basketball. Let's go. One lap, go, work. Change, change, faster, faster, faster. Let's go, let's go, let's go. You were first? Okay, wait. One lap and we wait, okay? Come on. Okay, stay over there, that group. Stay over there, that group. Okay? Here. Stay over there. Now here we are doing lateral jumps. Okay? Lateral. Ball up. Lateral jumps. Okay, same stuff, shoot the ball. Over there, same stuff because we have step side. Okay, just we are going to shoot the ball. Jump shot. Jump shot over there, jump shot over there. Go over there. Go over there. Come on, let's go. Let's go. Lateral jumps. Balance, we lift the ball over there because we want to work on balance, body core, and coordination. Come on, faster, 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 faster. Come on, let's go. Faster, one step up, one step down. Of course, you as a coach, you can put some coach over there. They can make give and go, hand off, whatever you want with one coach here. But usually you have not five assistants. We are not in NCAA, so you are alone. It's not easy to organize with five passers. So, but if you have personnel to do this, do it. You have different options. Come on, come on, faster, 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 faster. Let's go. Stop when you arrive. Milena, Milena, stop big man 18. Stop him. Go, 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 go. You finish. You are last. Okay, over there. We are doing the same, but one leg jump. One leg jump. Here, one leg jump. One side, one time left, one time right. First set, just left. Next right, okay? Okay, everything same, just one leg. This is methodology. Frontal, lateral, one leg. Come on, show to them. One leg jumps, come on, bravo. Explosive power of legs. Okay, bravo. Come on, let's go. Change direction and shoot the ball. Change direction, full speed, full speed, full speed. Go, go. When you're arriving over there, stop, say to him. When he arrives over there, to stop. Come on, come on, come on, let's go. Come on, let's go. It's not easy. I'm going to show to you after five practices they will do without problem. Come on, let's go. Lift your knees. Lift your knee. Wait now. Of course, coaches, if you want to put psychological pressure here, you can count who is going to score 10, who is going to score 5 in the roll. Every time try to connect technical pressure, they are going to change physical stuff and psychological pressure. Okay, here we are doing lateral jumps, but reversal. So you are going to do this. Jump, 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 jump. Over there, same stuff, but they are jumping frontally and then move and go back. Okay? Do you understand? Come on, let's go. No, no, two legs, 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 come on. So every time you are going back, bravo. Every time you are going back on one. Let's go, one more time here. Two more jumps here. Come on, jump, 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 two legs together. Jump, retro, jump here again. You should go back. Come on. Let's go, one, two, three, again. One, two, three. One, two, three, bravo. Come on, go. Jump shot. Try to connect the stuff. You can combine coaches here. Instead of shooting, you should make different kind of finishing, as I showed you before. Layup, reverse layup, extended layup, floater if you want, pull-up jumper after shot fake, pull-up jumper after pass fake. It's up to you. Okay? Let's go. Come on, full sprint, guys. So I'm asking you, coaches, this is not practice, this is demonstration. How many jumps they already made? It's very important to count. They are joking, they are playing, they are shooting, but they already made more than 100 jumps. This is our job, to be more effective than our colleagues in some other country. Okay, clean all the cones, hardless, except four cones here. Not you, Milena. Players, players. This is their working place. Come on, faster, guys. Clean everything except those three, four cones here. This drill, no. This, those cones, no. Next drill, you can do with 12 players together. But because it's drill for speed and agility, we are doing one group of four. Two groups are going outside, so ratio between work and rest is 1-2. So we can change. You should count this. You don't need to say to parents, to mothers, fathers, and to players, but you should count ratio between work and rest in order to be in metabolic zone, which you want to cover. I need four players. Come on, four players, everybody with ball. Come on, stay over there. Stay over there. You stay here. Ball, ball, ball. Everybody with ball. Okay. You stay here. Okay, four. You stay here and you stay over there. Okay? So, on the whistle, you should run to catch player in front of you. Run this direction. This direction. You should run to catch player in front of you. Smile. Come on. You are on the practice. You like much more basketball than something else. You are running this direction on the whistle. We work on speed reaction, agility, dribble skill, change direction, acceleration, deceleration. So many stuff. Ready? Come on, try to catch. Okay, finish. Next group, four guys. Come on. Opposite side. Now we are running left. We want to work on left hand dribble. Ready? Faster, faster, faster. Put the cone, Martin. Come on, come on, come on. Let's go faster, guys. Try to catch player in front of you. Also, eye hand coordination. Okay. So, according to the number of the players on the court, you are going to decide if you want to make groups of four or three or five. Depends on you. Okay, next group. Now we are doing something different. So on the first whistle, you are going to run this side. On the second, you change direction and go opposite side. This is more complex, but we are going to run. So change. Every whistle, you change direction. Okay? Ready? Okay, it's enough. So you are going to control, as I said before, if you want to decide in which metabolic zone you want to be, you are going to put cones closer. Because we don't want to work 45 seconds if you want to work on speed, agility, quickness, or something else. Okay, let's try to do the same now without ball, defensive stance. First group. First group. No balls. Martin. Martin, put cones a little bit closer. Defensive stance, just this direction. Try to catch him. Try to catch him. Come on, let's go. Okay, next group. Next group. Left side. Left side, come on. Ready? Ready? Stay down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down. Sit down, come on. Okay, let's go. Next group. We change again. First whistle, one direction, right. We start with right and we go on left. Ready? Okay, it's enough. Now, first group, four players. Put the cones on the same distance from the middle circle. Same distance like that cone. Okay, you are starting from here. Agility, acceleration, deceleration, running technique. Everybody start from here, one leg inside the circle. Okay? Okay, you start from this circle, you sprint around, you should touch circle with one leg. When you complete one run, who is going to touch first? Your cone is winner. Do you understand? So every time you are going here, here, so four sessions we have. Winner here, next group with ball. Next group with ball. So you have a lot of stuff to do here with same organization. If you need, if you want to do at the same time, you can put four cones over there, four cones in the middle, four cones over there. They can do at the same time. Okay, now with ball, okay, but we are going to dribble with weak side hand. You are all right-handers? Right-hander, right, left-hander? You are lefty, if I remember well. So you dribble with right. Left, you are a right-hander? No? Yeah. Yes, so you dribble with left. Weak side hand dribble. We are going on the right side. Go. So we want to work. Stop. This direction. Okay, start again. So you are going here. From this side, you are going over there. Ready? Come on. Come on, let's go. Faster. You are winner, you finish one lap, hey. Okay, next group without the ball. Stay in the circle. Okay, we are doing defensive slide, touch, go. Defensive, you don't need to go around, no around. Just go here, touch cone, go back and run over there on the next. Go a little bit closer, this cone is too away. Ready? Sit down, go. Touch, let's go, agility, go. Slide, move with slide. Next group, ready with ball, next group. Come on. Okay, now we are doing same stuff, but when you are running, this is more complex coordination. When you are doing defensive slide, give me ball, you are going to make crossover all the time. Okay, crossover, touch and go. It's difficult. Why you make this face? Start from here. Keep smiling. If you are making this face, go out of the practice, no problem. You don't need this. Come on. Let's go. Come on. Crossover all the time. Crossover all the time. Come on. Crossover all the time. Bravo. Let's go. Okay, it's enough. I need now... Let's make like this, four groups, three players. Let's make four groups, three players. Okay. Milena, give me... You are under the basket, one ball. Move cones out. Okay, give me four hardless here, out of the court here, yes. Four players here. Like this, put distance like this, okay. This is now practice for aerobic, drill for aerobic lactate endurance. Okay, we have three groups of four players. Four players, all of you, you have hurdle. Go over there. This is yours. Okay, it's enough, four is enough. We need five, one player. Take rest. Okay, you are here. You go out. You are here. Okay. Here, you are doing lateral jumps. Okay, all the time. This group over there, you are going to do fast break drill. Which fast break with three players you know? Figure eight? Yes? Okay, four players here without the ball. You are doing this drill for shoulders, no ball. you are doing here this position. Okay, ready? Come on, let's go. Are you ready? Figure eight, three players, four courts. We are going to start at the same time on the whistle, four courts, up and under. When they are doing four courts, you are jumping, you are doing stuff over there. When they finish, I will give you sign to stop. Okay, this is anaerobic lactate endurance. Four courts, they will do probably 20 seconds. Depends how, if they are well skilled or not. With under 16 Serbian team, I arrive on 16 courts. But they are under 16 with medical ball fast break. This is excellent way to develop endurance. Okay, ready everybody? Go. Come on, jumps all the time. Let's go, pass. They are not well organized to make figure eight, as you can see, so it's going to be 30. Let's make just with four passes. Come on, you go out, let's go. One, two, three, four. Come on, you can do it three, bravo. Go, jump. Come on, let's go, guys. Let's go. Okay. Bravo, okay, stop. So, I made mistake using four players. We should make groups of three. Okay, next group, three players over there. You're going over there. This group here, and we have three players to do here. Triceps. Three players. Okay. One, two, three. One more player here. One more guy here. Okay, did you see the reel? So, you're doing like this just. Okay, triceps stuff. You're doing this. You're doing same fast break jumps. Okay? Ready? Same stuff. One leg over, second leg over, go back. Second arm over. Did you see the reel? Come on, go. Ready? Stay with them. You're here. Three players. Come on. Ready, everybody? Go. Number 13, bring the ball. Seven out. 13, receive the ball. Come on. One, two, three. You go out. You get rebound. Go out. 13. Not you. You are on the side. Come on. Okay. It's fast break. Come on, guys. Three passes. Try to make without dribble. They can do it. Let's go. Four courts. It's enough. Okay. Milen, I need three cones here. Let's make group four players. This group here and one more guy. Come on, two balls. Same situation, similar drill, but something else. So just put cones to divide over there. One here and one over there. Okay, two players with ball over there. Over there. And two players with one ball over there. Okay. Here, bring the ball, all of you. All of you with balls. Here, you are doing agility. As we made before with arms, you are doing with legs. So you stay here in front of line, full sprint. Don't forget hardless, okay? You are playing one-on-one. One ball. So, number eight, you are defense. So, offense, defense. Four courts, same over there. We start at the same time, no, just this half court, okay? You attack here, after that, number four, you are attack here. We play just half court, one-on-one, okay? Here, over there, let's stay out in push-up position with ball. Okay, let's make this with one ball here and just change, okay? Not just change and make push. Do you know drill? Huh? Okay, extend your legs. Show me drill. Bravo. Okay, super. Ready? Go. Come on, faster. Let's go. Play one-on-one. If you get the ball, go attack over there. Come on, guys. Let's go faster. Let's go, guys. You are going to decide, coaches. If you want to make just two courts, it's going to be 15 seconds. If you might want to make four, 20, 25, 6, 30. So you are going to choose drills according to their ability to do something. So consider their ability before to ask for some drills. Okay? Okay, okay, it's enough. It's enough. Okay, of course you need to rotate all the players. Sometimes you don't need to make just one lap, three, four laps. If they are good in 10, 15 minutes, maximum 15 minutes, you cover anaerobic lactate endurance. This is enough for this age. When we are talking about anaerobic lactate endurance in under 14, you don't need to do more than two times per week. So maximum twice per week with 2 days rest between. So better to do Monday, Thursday, okay? Or if you are doing, I don't know, Wednesday, Saturday. So try to make separation between two sessions because anaerobic lactate endurance in under 14 should be worked carefully with players. You don't need to do something which can compromise their health. Okay, I need now four corridors for four hardless. Come on, let's go, number eight. Not you, Milena, number eight. Come on, let's make group three players. Come on. One here, like this. Yes, bravo. No, no, here, 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 here. Put over there. Okay, come on. Three players, this corridor, one ball. Two balls, sorry. Come on. We need two balls, three players, two balls. Come on. Pass to him. Who is with you? Okay, you stay this corridor. With ball, this is group, okay? You stay under the basket. This is your corridor. You stay over there, number 11, go opposite side. 11, you go opposite side. You're in the middle. Your corridor is last, your corridor. Okay, one group of players, three players here. Bring the ball, bring the ball. Number 9, come here. This is your hurdle. This is your line. Okay, this is your line. You have the ball, ball. Player without the ball. Come on, 14. Simple shooting drill with jumps. Okay, so you're going to jump over. Okay, sprint, pass to him. When you pass to him, you sprint over there. Jump over, shoot the ball. Three players, full court shooting drill. Simple, but with jumps. Older groups, or if you want to work more on jumping ability, you can put three, four hurdles, not one. Depends of you, okay? Now I'm just going to show, do you understand? Jump shot, 2 point shot, okay? So when you pass to him, you're going to sprint, jump, you receive, you are staying in this line, stay in your line. Okay, go, go, come on. Pass, 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 run, run, let's go. Jump over. Jump, two legs jumps, two legs jumps, come on. So you decide, 30 seconds, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. Let's go. Let's go, faster, faster, faster. Make two laps. Jump, two legs jumps, number 8. Two legs jumps, jump over, don't sprint over. Come on, two legs jumps, let's go. Okay. Now we are doing, we are adding complexity in the drill. It's related also to decision making. Okay, this, look what we are doing right now. Jump over, pass to him. Okay, sprint to make close out. You receive the ball on the 3 point level. Okay, jump stop, receive the ball. Okay, we are doing like this. Look, I'm you. You're going to pass to him, jump, jump stop. Now you're reading me. If I'm going to lift this arm here, one dribble over there, shoot the ball. Shoot the ball. We are working on shooting. We need shooters. We don't need drivers. We have enough drivers. Okay, one dribble, shoot. After that, you go to do the same. Same stuff, just we add closeout and decision making on defensive closeout. Okay? Okay, Don't do all the things on the same. Rotate here. Two players, one side. No, you go over there. Okay, go, go. Come on, come on. Pass to him. Close out, read, go, sprint, sprint. You finish your job. Jump, pass to him, close out, read, bravo, go. Change, change arm. Run, run, hey, run. Come on. After close out, just close out, run. Go, sprint, sprint. Come on, let's go. Come on, guys. Faster, faster, faster. Go to run. Let's go. So it's not easy. You can do here one leg jumps, lateral jumps, lateral one leg, zigzag with more hardless. It's up to you to be creative, to organize different kind of jumps in order to cover a lot of stuff. Okay? Okay, it's enough. It's enough. Everybody over there. Everybody over there, clean, clean, hardless, faster. Put Martin, Martin, one big, big cone, this big cone, one big cone here, and one over there, please. Okay, six players over there without the ball, six players here with ball, corner. Conditioning, close out of the dribble, close out, 101 skill. Okay, this is nice, I like very much this drill. I think it's good, so you are with him, huh? Okay, you start to dribble. Left hand, go back. I will show to you. So you start to dribble around this cone, and you attack this basket here. Okay, your offense. When he starts to dribble, you should sprint to touch sideline here, and you are sprinting to meet him to play defense 101. Okay, okay, you can start, stop, I say line. Outside of the court, on the corner. Go, come on. Meet him, attack him, attack him, attack him. Close the middle, don't let him go in the middle. Come on, next, next, next. Switch offense, defense, now go you over there. Come on, let's go. Let's go, attack him, defense. Attack him. Come on, let's go, next. Wait, wait. Come on, let's go. They are doing sprint, acceleration, stopping, agility, okay. Same drill, but when you finish to play 101 here, who get rebound, it's offense full court over there, 101. And when you are going back, you move on the side, outside of the court, and you should do like this, going back, outside of the court on the blue line. Okay? So, 101, 101, bear crawling back. Ready? Go. Come on, come on. Attack him, attack him, attack him. Come on, who get rebound offense? Who get rebound offense? Bravo, attack. Next, 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 go. Let's go, let's go. Who get rebound offense? Let's go. Pass ball and go over there. So shoulders, body core, dynamic power of shoulders. Let's go. Milena, stay over there. Martin, stay over there. They can use you to pass the ball. Wait, 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 wait. Come on, come on. Let's go. Let's go. Hey, you should go down. Okay, now we are doing, do you understand English? Do you understand English? You are going to do the same, but over there when you are going to play 101, you must to pass ball to Coach Milena or to Coach Martin. So 101 plus 1. Everything same. Okay, ready? Go. Come on, come on. Bravo, attack, pass, ball, play 101. Next, next. Go, sprint. Attack him, defender, attack him. Attack him, bravo, bravo, okay. Okay, very good. Let's go. Next. 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 Come on, sprint. Try to meet him. Put the pressure on the ball. Put the pressure on the ball. Okay, attack. Come on. One more time. One more time and you finish. Last group. When they finish, go. Okay? When they finish, you stay. You stay, you are doing. You are doing one more time. Come on, box out. Box out. Let's go. Let's go. Next group. Next group. Come on. Try to meet him. So, I don't need to explain to you all the skills. Intentionally, I put them on the left side because we want to work on left, on weak side dribble. Okay, now we are going to make some games. You can do this also in mini basket, different skills. Let's make two groups because they are tired. Okay, left this cone over there. 6-6. One ball. One ball. I prefer with kids we have 6-7 minutes more. I prefer to finish practice in the beauty. That means some games. They like to play. As I said in previous session to local coaches here, if you're going to say to kids you should make 10 sprints in the end of the practice, they will say crazy coach from Serbia. They will find some injury or something. So you should put the oil on the fire, making them some drills. So like this, they are going to make full sprint. Okay, we are doing like this because they are familiar with left and right hand. Six players, we have one more. Okay, one player on the side. You should start to sprint to dribble with right, the left hand, left hand layup. You are going to dribble right hand and right hand layup. If you miss, you must score. When you score, you pass to the next player. Game is over when first player is lifting ball up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ready? So you should score. If you miss layup, you should score and then pass ball to your teammate. Okay? Go. Go. Come on. Faster, faster, faster. Come on, let's go. You miss, you should score. Again. Come on, let's go. Next. Of course, you can make shorter distance if you want to work more on speed. You can make here 3-point level. Depends of you. You can make also four teams. Four teams by three. If you want to have ratio between work and rest, 1-2, four groups, three players. If you want to work on speed, as we are doing right now, 1-5. One player is doing, five players are resting. So this is ratio for speed. Let's go, faster, faster, faster. Come on. Let's go, last one. Faster, when you receive the ball, lift ball up. Come on, let's go. One, zero. Okay, next game. Now you're going to make figure eight between legs. This is like lunge. Very important for basketball players, gluteal part, hamstrings. So we are working like this, full sprint, half court, over there, full sprint layup. Okay? Go. This is like lunge. We want to imitate movement like in the lunge. Again, if you say to kids you should make 50 lunge, they will say crazy Serbian coach. Like this, they are smiling and they are doing stuff as they want. Come on, let's go. Milena, Martin, prepare one more ball. Okay, we have. Okay, let's go, let's go, let's go. Faster, 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 faster. Not now, not now, wait. Come on guys, let's go. Try to score every time, pass to him. Let's go, let's go. Okay, finish, finish, finish. Okay, bring another ball. Two balls each player. So you're going to dribble two balls at the same time. Okay, when you are arriving here, pass ball to your teammate and go to make layup. But two balls together. Coordination again. Two balls, ball handling. Let's go. Come on, faster. Two balls together. Two balls together. Sit down, stay low. If you want to make life difficult, you as a coach, you can stay here. You can stay here. If you want to work on peripheral vision, you can stay here and show to them numbers. So they should lift head and look for you to show numbers. Okay, add something again. Let's go, faster. Come on, score, go, next, come on. Together. Very important also, coaches, here you can put one normal ball, one ball without the air. So it's also proprioception or tennis ball, basketball, volleyball ball, basketball. So like this, it's very difficult for them to handle two different balls at the same time. Okay, you can do next drill with alternate dribble, but we are not going to do. We are not going to do because we have no time. Let's make like this right now. One ball on the floor. So coordination, leg, eye, hand. Now you're going to dribble with one ball and you're going to dribble one ball with leg. Okay? Don't shoot on the basket right now. Okay? We are not shooting. So you're going to dribble and to roll the ball to play football. Okay? Doesn't matter. Okay? No shooting. Now you just move around, you should give to the next player. Okay, you don't need to shoot. Ready? Go. As you can see, it's not easy. Also for senior players, it's very difficult. Probably some senior players are going to break ankle here. Let's go. It's interesting, end of the practice, interesting for them. Good for us because we are working on different kind of coordination. Come on, let's go. One minute and we are finished. On the time. Okay. Yes, okay. 10 minutes 15, we are on schedule right now. So 15 minutes, 5:15, and we are going to finish at 6:30. 6:30, yes. Okay, let's go, guys. Let's go. Also here, coaches, when you are going to give them games, you can check psychological status of players. Who wants to do first? Probably can be leader. But probably you should have some talented players who are going to be last one. You don't need to left them. So push them to be first. So also psychologically you should handle different personalities in order to use all the players in the right way. Okay, it's enough. Let's make like this now. Six players over there. Let's go you over there. Six players here. We need five balls. Let's make one player here. Okay, one player over there. And four players with ball here. You are here. Okay, you are outside. No, stay over there. You are running on this basket. Okay, same here, guys. One player here, 11. Stay over there in the fast break without ball. Without the ball. Pass to them. Number 8, come here. Bring all of you balls. I like to finish practice with shooting because in the end of the game we should score. Very simple drill for shooting. Let's try three-point shots. You can score for free. Yes, bravo. Okay, you just pass and you just follow the ball. So you pass to him and run on his place. You pass to him, one dribble, three-point shots. And you sprint over there and go on the opposite line. Okay? So full court, fast break shooting. Again, we can make psychological pressure, counting who is going to score, 5, 10, 5 in the roll, 3 in the roll, whatever you want. Okay? Do you understand drill? Okay? Go! 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 Come on! Come on! Come on! Pass! Next! 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 Go! Next! Next! Pass! Shoot the ball! Go! Next! Come on! Run faster! Here! 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 Come on! Let's go! Pass! 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 Go to run here! Go to run! Come on! Pass! Pass! Run! So, different skills, running, passing, shooting, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, it's up to you. Let's go, let's go! Come on, faster, guys! Fast break, running, shooting, passing. Simple but good. Okay, it's enough. We are out of time. Please, big applause for players. Guys, 10 minutes, 10 minutes rest. Okay, so coaches, from the beginning of the practice, I think that we made all the stuff which basketball players are doing on the game. This is very important, to connect. It wasn't practice. But think how many jumps, how many sprints, how many changes of direction they made. So that was demonstration for you. Think if you're going to push them to do stuff. I'm asking you. It was too much for under 14? I don't think so. That's supposed to be something normal. So if you count, probably they made 200 jumps. They made more than 100 sprints. They made change of direction. They made layup. They made reverse layup. They make extended layup. They make shoot for two. They make shoot for three. I hope it was interesting for them. But it's important that we cover a lot of aspects of conditioning together with basketball skills. That was our goal, if you remember. It's a tough day, but if you remember from the beginning of the practice, that was topic. So I think that you should always combine basketball skills with simple stuff, with conditioning skills or conditioning abilities which you want to cover on your practice. Consider windows of trainability and consider part of the week and part of the practice when you want to use some specific conditioning ability. Any question, coaches?